than 2 million people in the United States become sick from antibiotic-resistant bacteria each year. Resistance occurs when bacteria in your body change, making antibiotics that were once used to fight the bacteria no longer effective. This can happen when you are given antibiotics you may not need, making bacteria strong enough to change and resist the antibiotic. Of those who get sick, 20,000 do not survive. And those who do survive may require longer treatment time, have higher healthcare costs, spend more time in the hospital, and develop more complications. Antibiotic stewardship programs can help. These programs help ensure people get the right antibiotic, the right dose at the right time, and for the right length of time. So how did antibiotic resistance become a problem? When used properly, antibiotics save lives and help your body fight infections by killing bacteria. However, some bacteria escape the medication and become resistant to the antibiotics. These bacteria increase and can cause the person to get sick again. When this happens, different antibiotics are needed to kill the bacteria, increasing the chance of even more bacteria becoming resistant, making you sick longer, requiring additional medication and costing more money. Additional antibiotics could also lead to serious side effects. This brings us to nursing homes. Antibiotics are among the most commonly prescribed drugs in nursing homes. On any given day, more than 10% of residents are taking an antibiotic. In addition, residents living together in a group setting, especially those who travel between the nursing home and hospital or dialysis centers, run the risk of transferring bacteria to other residents. Because of these reasons, experts have seen a high rate of antibiotic resistance in many nursing homes. But what can be done? Besides practicing safe hygiene like hand washing, we must promote the use of antibiotics only when they can help and only when the antibiotics are necessary. We must remember the more we use antibiotics, the more likely resistant bacteria will develop and spread. Mrs. Parker is a 74-year-old nursing home resident with dementia who started taking antibiotics for a urinary tract infection, or UTI. During her treatment, she developed bloody diarrhea, along with abdominal cramps and a low-grade fever. She tested positive for Clostridium difficile toxin, or C. diff. This infection developed because the antibiotics killed much of her normal bacteria, leaving space for more dangerous bacteria to take over. Her C. diff infection was a side effect of taking antibiotics and could have been severe or life-threatening if untreated. People living in nursing homes are frequently prescribed antibiotics for urinary tract infections. However, many UTIs are misdiagnosed. If a urine culture shows bacteria, a common practice has been to give an antibiotic. However, we now know that in older people, sometimes bacteria can be in the bladder without causing an infection or harm. For that reason, a positive urine culture in a person without any symptoms should not be treated with an antibiotic. Before giving an antibiotic, assess the resident for infectious signs or symptoms. If none are present, take steps to monitor the resident and make sure they are feeling well and do not develop new symptoms. This is new information for many people, yet now considered a standard of care. What can you do to help stop antibiotic-resistant bacteria in the nursing home? If you are a resident or family member, you should talk with your medical team about the benefits and harms of antibiotics. Do not request an antibiotic when your doctor says it is not needed, and do not take an antibiotic for a virus such as a cold or the flu. If you or your family member are prescribed antibiotics, find out why the antibiotic was prescribed. You could ask, are antibiotics necessary? Are there any alternatives? Can we hold off on the antibiotics for a couple days and closely monitor the symptoms? When should the antibiotic be discontinued? If you and your provider decide you could benefit from an antibiotic, take it as prescribed for as long as ordered and ask, how should the antibiotic be taken? How much antibiotic is needed, and what side effects should I look for and report? Finally, if you are a staff member in a nursing home, encourage residents and family members to ask questions so they will understand whether or not an antibiotic is needed. Antibiotics are certainly necessary and important in certain situations, but you can help yourself and others by encouraging the use of antibiotics only when they are needed. We cannot stop antibiotic resistance, but we can slow it down. Remember, don't take antibiotics just in case. Take them only when needed.